Blackstone Audiobooks is pleased to present The Light in the Piazza by Elizabeth Spencer, read by Hilary Huber, directed and produced by Patrick Fraley.
1. On a June afternoon at sunset, an American woman and her daughter fended their way along a crowded street in Florence and entered with relief the spacious Piazza della Signoria. They were tired from a day of tramping about with a guidebook, often in the sun. The café that faced the Palazzo Vecchio was a favorite spot for them. Without discussion, they sank down at an empty table. The Florentines seemed to favor other gathering places at this hour. No cars were allowed here, though an occasional bicycle skimmed through, and a few people, passing, met in little knots of conversation, then dispersed. A couple of tired German tourists, all but harnessed in fine camera equipment, sat at the foot of Cellini's triumphant Perseus, slumped and staring at nothing. Margaret Johnson, lighting a cigarette, relaxed over her aperitif and regarded the scene that she preferred before any other, anywhere. She never got enough of it, and now, in the clear evening light that all the shadows had gone from, the sun being blocked away by the tight bulk of the city, she looked at the splendid old palace and forgot that her feet hurt. More than that, here she could almost lose the sorrow that for so many years had been a constant of her life. About the crenellated tower where the bells hung, a few swallows darted. Margaret Johnson's daughter, Clara, looked up from the straw of her orangeade. She, too, seemed quieted from the fretful mood to which the long day had reduced her.
"What happened here, Mother?"
"Well, the statue over there, the tall white boy, is by Michelangelo. You remember him. Then, though it isn't a very happy thought, there was a man burned to death right over there, a monk." Any story attracted her.
"Why was he burned?"
"Well, he was a preacher who told them they were wicked, and they didn't like him for it. People were apt to be very cruel in those days. It all happened a long while ago. They must feel sorry about it, because they put down a marker to his memory."
Clara jumped up. "I want to see!"
She was off before her mother could restrain her. For once, Margaret Johnson thought, "Why bother?" In truth, the space before them, so satisfyingly wide, like a pasture, might tempt any child to run across it. To Margaret Johnson, through long habit, it came naturally now to think like a child. Clara, she now saw, running with her head down to look for the marker, had bumped squarely into a young Italian. There went the straw hat she had bought in Fiesole. It sailed off prettily, its broad red ribbon a quick mark in the air. The young man was after it. He contrived to knock it still farther away, once and again, though the day was windless. His final success was heroic. Now he was returning, smiling, too graceful to be true. They were all too graceful to be true. Clara was talking to him. She pointed back toward her mother. Oh, Lord, he was coming back with Clara. Margaret Johnson, confronted at close range by two such radiant young faces, was careful not to produce a very cordial smile.
"We met him before, Mother. Don't you remember?"
She didn't. They all looked like carbon copies of one another. He gave a suggestion of a bow.
"My store."
English was coming out.
"It is near Piazza della Repubblica. How do you say? The big square. Oh, yes, and on Sunday si fanno la musica. Music, boom, boom."
He was a whole orchestra, though his gestures were small.
"And the lady?"
Now a busty Neapolitan soprano sprang to view, in pink lace, one hand clenched to her heart. Margaret Johnson could not help laughing. Clara was delighted. Ah, he had pleased. He dropped the roll at once.
"My store is there."
A chair was vacant. "Please?" He sat. Here came the inevitable card. They were shoppers, after all, or would be. Well, it was better than compliments, offers to guide them.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.